But my name's Owen, I'm a graphic designer. Been there 10 years now. Got into design from an art-based background, and what this talk is about is kind of my rediscovery of drawing on location. So that's me drawing something. Right. So as a designer, you spend a lot of your time on the computer, ideas, and as much as I enjoy that, I've missed drawing. It's a lot of time, you don't have time to develop concepts and sketches and you're going straight onto a map. So for me, drawing a location is a release from that and it's getting back to what I love first of all. For me, it starts with sketchbook, which is really a central part of any being as an artist or anything. Really, you can develop your own kind of personal dialogue with yourself, developing a personal visual language, not how the world is looking at from a piece and then using it from just an idea of being a drawing. But never care about yourself. So I'm quickly just referencing life drawing really. I mean, I think life drawing is a very important part of drawing and practicing artistry. Really. You've got the kind of academic stuff in this about life drawing possibly sitting there and on the charcoal drawing, but I mean that isn't the best drawing, but I've not approached it in general in a standard way. But I've done a drawing model, but I'll just draw some people, draw the easel, draw everything, you know, I think you can get what you want out of anything really. When I go out drawing now, this is my kind of kit I take with me. Basically, if you're outdoors, you can pair back what you take with you. You might be tempted to bring all colouring pencils, pastels, all manner of things, but a lot of the time, it's going to be too much to handle. So, travel watercolour set, a couple of brushes, pens, and a camera if I run out of time. Sketchbooks, size is really what it's about. I mean, you can have larger books if you're working outdoors, it's more of a kind of broader scene you want to capture. But for me, I was starting with pocket sketchbooks because they're very handy to use and you can use them in tight spaces and be less intrusive and you can get away with hopefully not getting noticed. Which brings me to this project, which, I mean, coming from a design background, you kind of used to work into briefs and projects. So I set myself a task of, I was living in London and I was commuting on the tube for 9 months. I thought, well, this is great, I've got all this material in front of me here. So I basically drew everyone on the tube that I saw for about 9 months. I brought several books really full up. And you can just make funny observations like what people are wearing, things like that. That then led me to create a mural based on those drawings. It's like 3 meters by 2 meters, based on the faces that I saw. And it's kind of mini portraits and observations, you know, just the thought, but, you know, where are these people going? What's the background? And that always intrigued me. Obviously, after doing the tube drawings, I then sort of wanted to get outside a bit more, so I started to draw the kind of streets around me. We were living in Muswell Hill at the time. There's lots of nice, characterful kind of independent shops and old architecture there, so I would go out and draw buildings and things and then colour them later on the computer. This is before I really used watercolour, so I was more confident using the computer for colour. And then venturing further into London, I started to draw landmarks and things. Kind of feel like, okay, everyone knows what Big Ben looks like, but when you actually stand in front of it and draw it, you kind of have to count, you know, how many of those, you know, how big the clock face is compared to the top, you know, how many columns there are in St. Paul's, and all these things. When you draw something, you really see it, I think. You take a photo of something, when you draw it, you really see it. This drawing was made during a day out with this the London Urban Sketches group. They have these so-called sketch calls where you meet up and you draw location to location. And we in London tried to swear that day, so I drew that. I met this chap, Ren, on that day, who's a brilliant artist, got me to use watercolours really. When I was younger, I used to be involved in skateboarding, and this is drawn during a sort of anniversary jam for a thing to celebrate the Save the South Bank campaign, so that's possibly going to be redeveloped and talk quicker. This is a Japanese restaurant I drew out on a work night out. They encouraged me to draw this chef who's cooking food in front of me. I drew that there and then, about a minute or something. And then on the next slide, you'll see, thanks to social media, then I put it online, and the restaurant themselves picked up on that and asked if I could use it on their Facebook page. So it's very nice this time. And then I sent them a high-res print, and they actually gave it to the chef who was cooking our food. So it was quite a sweet story. He looked so happy with it. Moved back to Norwich last summer, and I felt like I came back with fresh eyes really, because now I was sort of wanting to draw it again. I was drawing familiar places, I was in a train station there. Now this was drawn in a 20-minute window before I was getting the train, which was quite nice because it gives you a kind of time scale to work to, and that for me was the right amount of time there, if you don't have time to fuss out details. I'm a graphic designer for Virgin Money at the moment, and we have several of these kind of formal stand-up things for announcements and things. That's the CEO of Virgin Money, Jay Mann, announcing Virgin Money's intention to float in the stock exchange. I drew this picture and then presented it to her the next visit, and she said she loved it. She said she was going to frame it and put it in her office. I haven't got proof of that. One evening, myself and my partner Carly, we also walked around Norwich and wanted to kind of see firsthand what it was like for homeless people living in Norwich. It was quite a few homeless people in Norwich. It was a real insight really. This chap, Tim, as the head of set, grew up in an 8-bedroom house, got a lovely story, life story really, and so I drew that while we were talking to him. This is another way of drawing on location. This is a proposed, well, it's going to be an Asda on Bessemer Road, and I drew the location first in the top left before I knew it would be developed. It's now been flattened, that site. It's been made into an Asda, but it's quite an interesting thing because that kind of captures that process. You never want to be there anymore. This was drawn during Record Store Day, but being a recent convert to enjoy the vinyl, I was aware of this and how you get these limited edition releases on the day. So I needed to be a big queue. So I thought I'd go to select shop about 9 o'clock, and I've captured the queue and the people. And it's not only a place, it's an event. I think that's what I like about drawing on locations and capture what's going on. Recently I've been doing drawings of houses for people for commissions. This is a chap I work with, Sean. It's lovely. Jordan townhouse. It's actually an old brewery, a brewery house that's called. And when they were doing well, they extended to that top floor has been built on a successful year. But they're quite nice to do. Things with homes, they mean so much to some people really. Just a building that looks in his home, it means a lot more. This is the last slide, just showing that, you know, I continue to mess about with styles. So this